What's up, guys? Welcome to 456. I'm Tobin.
And I'm Jesse, and we are so glad you are joining us today.
That's right. And it's a great time to get moving and worship God with our singing and our dancing, don't you think?
Oh yeah, for sure. So let's sing this one out all together.
Surrounded, your love is everywhere and I'm surrounded. It's got me singing, it's got me shouting, and now I wanna tell the world about it. Cause now I am alive, yeah, you opened up my eyes. Everywhere I look, I see.
Amazing job, everyone. Keep up the energy for one more song. I know you've got it in you.
Yeah, and let's actually take it up another notch because this is a brand new song.
Let's do this.
In the middle of the dark night, I can't see the sunlight. It's gonna be alright, I won't be afraid, no. When the waves are crashing and lightning is flashing, I'll still be standing, I won't be afraid. Cause you light the dark, you fill my heart with courage. When I'm afraid, Jesus, you are my hope. I call your name, you keep me safe, your strength is perfect. I will trust in you alone. You are my hope. You are my hope. Even when I can't see what lies in front of me, I know you're with me. I won't be afraid, no.
guys did great with that new one, mm-hmm. but you must be tired, so go ahead and take a seat.
So far this month, we have been looking at different parts of the Bible that teach us about commitment, which is making a plan and then putting it into practice. And can I just say, we have learned a lot so far.
Yeah, we have. And I've actually started adding some new things into my morning routine, like reading my Bible mm-hmm. and taking some time to pray and not just biceps, so.
Tobin, I don't know how you have so much time in the morning. I just always feel like I'm rushing just to make sure I even remember to brush my teeth.
I mean,
anyone relate?
It's actually about taking one small step at a time, you know. I only started praying for a few minutes a day, and now it's started to grow into a longer and longer periods of time.
I should definitely think about trying that, for sure. Well, I think the guys at the So-and-So Show know exactly what you're talking about, too. So let's check it out now.
It's always been my dream to be a street luger. Going down steep inclines at incredible speeds while lying on my back, feeling the wind in my back. And today is the day that dream comes true. Nothing is gonna get in my way. Oh, I forgot my helmet!
John!
Oh, Brandon! Brandon, thank you for rescuing me! I can't do it! I'm so scared! I can't be a street loser!
Well, if it's any consolation, John, you'll always be a loser to me.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to The So-and-So Show. I am Brandon.
And I am John. Chew your words. Chew your words.
We've got a great day planned for you. Isn't that right, John? Yeah is German for yes, in case you were wondering.
Rubber baby buggy bumpers. Rubber baby buggy bumpers. Cantaloupe can't loop a lot. Cantaloupe can't loop a lot.
We have a very special guest coming up on the show, and John is a little nervous about it.
Miss Millicent Protzig, my theater teacher. Theater!
That's right.
She'll
be here in a minute.
Uh-huh. I recently auditioned for a community theater production of War and Peace, the musical, and I got cast in a role, so I need some help with my enunciation.
Enunciation, huh? I'm pretty good at that, but why don't you, just in case, explain what enunciation is to the folks out there?
All right. It is the practice of clearly pronouncing your words so they are easy for everyone to hear and understand.
I'm sorry, could you repeat that?
It is the practice
I'm
of-
I'm kidding. Oh. Please welcome someone who knows stuff.
I have arrived.
Come on in and have a seat.
Nonsense! When you sit, you lose all of your energy. Everyone stand!
Oh. Hello, Ms. Protzig.
Jonathan, it is so good to see you. I hear you need help with your enunciation.
He sure does.
What was that?
I was just saying that he sure...
Dear boy, I cannot understand a word that you're saying.
I do need help with enunciation, Ms. Protzig.
It appears that you're not the only one.
Wait, are you referring to me?
No idea what you're saying.
No, I just...
Shh! Prattle no longer, my weak-lipped friend. It is time to play the ancient theater game known as... Spittle Spattle!
Spittle Spattle!
This exercise will allow you to let your salivary glands and your vocal folds go.
Salivary glands?
I will give you a phrase to say. You will take a sip of water and then proceed to say the phrase as distinctly as possible.
Why?
What did he say?
He said, why?
Well, every good stage actor knows that the more you spit when you speak, the more clearly understood you will be.
Oh.
Again, no clue.
I just said, oh.
Let us begin. Take a sip. And repeat after me. Bombastic prepositions.
Prepositions.
Bombastic
prepositions.
Again.
Bombastic prepositions. Bombastic prepositions.
You both need to use your lips, your lungs, and your loudness more. Take another sip. Second phrase. Pumpernickel pretzel bites.
Pumpernickel pretzel bites. Pumpernickel pretzel bites.
Oh, much, much better. Now, one more. Mm-hmm. 55 feet of frivolous, flimsy flapjacks.
Fifty-five feet of frivolous, flimsy flapjacks.
Wonderful. Now, let's see who won.
Oh, how can you tell?
Shh, just let her do her thing.
Well, clearly, Jonathan is the more advanced expectorator.
Oh, wow. Thanks, Miss Protzig.
He's what?
What?
Come on.
I'm the best spitter.
Indeed you are. You are fully prepared for your upcoming production. By the by, what part did you get?
I'm tree number two.
Tree number two? You know, as I say, there are no small parts. Only I exit stage right. Oh.
Wow, isn't that great?
Time with Kellen.
What?
It's...
What is up?
Kellen!
Whoa. Brandon, I've never heard you speak so clearly.
Really? Chalk it up to the genius of Miss Protzig.
What have you got for us, Kellen?
Man, I mean really clear. Anyway, today we're talking about a very important practice that everyone needs to learn. I'm talking about prayer. When it comes to praying, Jesus set a great example for us. He never missed an opportunity to spend time alone with his Heavenly Father. Jesus even taught his disciples how to pray. Today, we call that the Lord's Prayer. What is... Oh, no.
Glad you came. Glad you're here. I know it's getting late, but never fear. We'll give a blow-by-blow of the Bible story on the Mel Solomon Story Recap.
Kellen, buddy. So glad to have you back on my show.
I'm Melv Solomon, and this handsome fella tickling the ivories right over here is my brother-in-law, Greg. Say hello, Greg.
Always the scene stealer, that Greg. You're a scene stealer, am I right? How could he not be with that handsome mug?
Hey, Melv.
Yeah, Kellen, what's going on, mi compadre?
Just trying to teach everyone about the Lord's Prayer.
Lord's Prayer? I love the Lord's Prayer. Say no more, Kellen. I'd be happy to jump in with a little ditty from time to time. Don't have to ask me twice.
But I didn't ask you once.
Ah!
So Jesus' disciples asked him to teach them how to pray. Jesus replied, "When you pray, this is what you should say. Father, may your name be honored. May your kingdom come." So when you pray, you can start by telling God how amazing he is.
beautiful words for a beautiful ditty. Hit it, Greg. Greg. Greg!
I have a handsome mug.
Stayed up a little late watching the telly, didn't you? I knew it. Play the tune. That's the one. God, you're great. God, you're awesome. When you made the universe, you weren't playing opossum. You're the best, you're the top, you're the cream of the crop. But I'm still confused why you made mosquitoes. Back to you, Kellen.
All right. Next, Jesus told his disciples to pray this. Give us each day our daily bread.
Oh, I got the perfect song for that one. Hit it, Greg. Greg.
Greg! It's a cup with a handle.
Play the song, Greg.
Yeah.
Now we're cooking. You say holla, I say ciabatta. You say sourdough, I say soda. Challah, ciabatta, sourdough, soda. Just don't forget I'm gluten-free. What a prayer, Kellen. What a prayer.
Uh-huh. Just to be clear, God wasn't saying to only pray for different kinds of bread. Jesus was telling us to be open and honest about the needs in our life. God wants to hear about it all. Jesus finished his prayer this way. Forgive us our sins as we also forgive everyone who sins against us. Keep us from falling into sin when we are tempted. Let's be honest. We all make bad choices from time to time. We all sin. We all need forgiveness. So Jesus reminded us to go to God for that forgiveness and to ask him to help us make wiser choices. And also, we should be willing to forgive people when they've sinned against us.
Love it. Love it. How about I sing one more tune summing up the whole shebang?
I don't think that's really necessary.
Hit it, Greg. Greg. Greg.
I'm awake.
Oh.
Coffee.
Yes. Sorry about that. Let's wrap this up. Atta baby. Who's awesome? You are. Who gives me what I need? You do. Who forgives me? That's you, 'cause it's just what you do. Remind me to love people how you've shown you love me. Who feels better? That's me, 'cause I talk to you.
I'm not gonna lie, that was lovely.
I know.
Let's hear that whole prayer one more time. Father, may your name be honored. May your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we also forgive everyone who sins against us. Keep us from falling into sin when we are tempted.
That's beautiful, Kellen. Hey, Greg, how about I take you out for a fresh loaf of bread to go with that mug of Joe, huh? All right, catch you later, Kellen.
Bye, Mel.
I'm outie. I didn't mean right now, Greg. Meant after the show.
So, what'd you guys think of the Lord's Prayer?
I think it's great. I've already got it memorized. Ready?
Father, may your name be honored. May your kingdom come.
Sounds great, but you know you don't have to say it all proper like that. God will totally understand even if you don't pronounce each word perfectly. You don't even have to use the exact words Jesus used.
So we don't just recite this prayer?
Well, you can if you want, but you can totally pray it in your own words too. We can tell God he's awesome, ask for him to provide for our needs, ask for forgiveness when we mess up, and tell him everything we need help with. It's important to speak from the heart.
I just think that it's amazing that the creator of the universe actually loves to hear from us.
You're right about that.
Hey, thanks for the story, Kellen.
Ah, no problem. It's what I do. I'll see you guys.
I'm glad we learned how to pray today. I'm going to need all the help I can get to play the pivotal role of tree number two, right? Red leather, yellow leather, red leather, yellow leather.
Well, your enunciation is going to be great. Hey, what are your lines?
Red leather, yellow leather. I don't have any lines. I'm a tree.
Yoda met Yeti on the plains of Serengeti. Yoda met Yeti on the plains of Serengeti. Yoda met Yeti.
Reveal the question!
Oh, how do you pray to God?
Do you sing or whisper?
Do you pray in your head or pronounce everything with perfect enunciation and sizzle?
Do you pray inside or outside, in the dark or upside down in a tree? However you pray, talk about it with each other.
Yeah, hey, hey, learn something from each other.
And we'll see you next time on The So-and-So Show! The So-and-So Show. Am I saying that right?
Yes.
The So. And chew your words.
Chew your words.
So-and-So Show.
No problem, cover coffee, man.
Inexplicably, okay. Mimicking him hiccuping.
Inexplicably mimicking.
The main thing to remember about praying, guys, is just to be honest. Say what you mean and mean what you say. Pray earnestly. Care about those you pray for. God will hear you. He always does. And you can trust God in everything and in this, no matter what. Think about this question today. How do you pray to God?
Is it something you do quickly, not thinking about it? Or do you actually want to hear what He has to say? If you're not sure how you'd answer that question, don't worry about it. Prayer might be something new to a lot of people, but just taking those small steps to practice will help you grow with your relationship with God. As we head out, let's pray and talk to God. Dear God, thank you so much for prayer. We thank you for that line of communication between you and us. We thank you for always being there to listen to us and to help us when we need it. God, we thank you for all you do and all the people that you've put in our lives. It's all in your son's name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thanks so much for joining us today. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram at SVKids and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Sun Valley Kids.
Now, 456 is almost here. To register, you can head to summer.sv.cc and you can join us in all the fun we're going to have up north.
Seriously, it's going to be a great time. So we'll see you next time.
Bye. Bye.
Have you ever decided to do something really big? Like learn how to play guitar? Or, make friends with the new kid down the street? Maybe you even want to bake a master chef-worthy cake for your mom's birthday. You're super excited to get started, but then you sit down with the guitar and...
Oh, no.
Or you spend all morning working up the nerve to go knock on the new kid's door and... turns out he's gone for a week of summer camp. Then you find the recipe for that amazing cake, and it's crazy. Doing big things takes work. It takes making a plan and then sticking with it. There are calluses along the way, patience and courage in building a friendship, and definitely some mess. But when you follow through, you find the music, you grow a friendship, you create amazing edible art. And through it all, others can see how God has given you the strength to stick with it. That's why commitment is an amazing way to worship God with your life, because worship is about more than just singing loud. It's all about living loud.